in the village, these cranes look like little creatures, grazing. I had no idea how huge they are. Most of what I've seen from the outside world probably arrived in a cart like this. Traders used to come to the outskirts of the village. The war put an end to this. Before the war, the village exported treatments created by Dr. Fumio. These packages never made it to their destination. Before setting up in Caro village, Dr. Fumio roamed the land curing people. It must have been hard when he wasn't around anymore, especially for people who couldn't travel to the village. I feel nourished in these sights, by the unfamiliarity of it all. These means of connection, long in disuse, are certainly telling me something about the world. Will they be used again in the next season? that poor baby. They were right. The letter never made it. The season before this one, the war, seems so horrible. I can see in these letters that the outside world has extremes of beauty and tragedy beyond anything I've known. The irony of Caro is that it's a closed-off place on the outskirts of a busy trading hub. A postal hub we hardly used is practically on our doorstep. I heard at some point the tides got less predictable. Places flooded that never had before. I forgot what I was going to say. We learned about old technology in school, but not much about animals. What are these strange goat-like creatures? Are they simply goats? My first time petting an animal. I think it went pretty well. It felt off. I guess I had beginner's luck before. Okay, now I got it back. I'm in control. I can easily pet certain four-legged animals. I heard that village was abandoned because of a mind disease. Not every community had someone like Dr. Fumio to perform cures. Ha ha ha! crane to move materials around. The things that used to be possible. I cycled through landscapes, seeing them for the first and last time. I had no idea when I left my home how the season would end, or more importantly, how soon. On a cold, damp day, I feel true loneliness for the first time. Nobody could have described with words how big this world is, how it goes and goes. I passed through it, where others passed before me.